apostolic anointing.
That's right.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Glory to God. See you in the ocean.
All right.
Oh, no, 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 no.
All
shut
right.
up. We tend to sit them down too much. You know, I don't mind babies coming around me in the pulpit. You know, because I look at look at how Jesus ministered, and the children would come up to him, and when they come up to him, the disciples began to forbid them. And the Bible tells me that Jesus said, "Suffer the little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of heaven." He said, "It's better than a millstone hung about your neck and cast into the depths of the sea for you to harm one of my little ones." This is God's little lambs. Glory to God. So a lot of preachers have problems with them coming up. I don't have no problem with it. I'm going to shake it. Because you don't know where your healing going to come from. You don't know where your deliverance going to come from. You don't know what's going to set you free. And if you forbid no children, your healing. Your healing could be there. Your deliverance could be there. There's an anointing of prosperity already on these children.
All right, Lord. Have your way with
you. Glory to God.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Just one touch.
Right.
See, we don't know how Jesus is going to use whoever. Even while the song was playing, the little baby came up there like this.
All right. All right.
He said, the man of God need a touch.
Amen. Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
So I'm telling y'all, mom and daddy, Amen. Harness that gift.
Amen.
Culture it.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, God.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Right.
I just want to spend a few minutes on this because sometimes we do not do what we're supposed to do.
That's right.
And when little babies come up to her, they ain't, not now. But that baby got something that you need.
All right.
Even if you don't understand what they're saying, they understand what they're saying because, believe it or not, them babies see angels.
Yes, they do.
Glory to God. So it's two reasons they can come to you. It's one, if they see an angel around you. Or two, they see you need a healing touch. Glory to God. I feel my help coming right now. Glory to God. I feel energized right now. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So I don't ever forbid the babies to come to me. Jesus said not to do it, so who am I? You know, we don't got so flamboyant in the church. We tell the baby, stay out of the pulpit. See, I was talking. Because see, there's an purity in those children. Glory to God. And then they ain't gonna come to you if they don't feel safe by you. Glory to God. See, they look on me and they say, I know he's a spoiler. Glory to God. You're going to give me something. Huh? They know they don't have to ask long. They know he's going to give me something. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank God for them babies. Giving honor to the pastor and his wife and shepherding this great flock. I bid you greetings in the name of our Lord Savior Jesus Christ. And I give honor to my wife and my children. Glory to God. And we thank God for being here. And we thank God for being here in another night. Glory to God. I told y'all I was going to bring part two.
Amen.
These robes are fancy, but they get on my nerves when I'm preaching. You know, the bun is fine, but you know, I gotta be free. You know, you know how it is when you don't want nothing tying you up in your Y'all, I feel like shouting up in this place. Glory to God. Because see, one thing about it, if you enter his gates with thanksgiving, enter his courts with praise, if you be thankful unto him and bless his name, see, there's a praise on the inside. Glory to God. I know, it's always happening like this in the second day of the service. You know, glory to God. Glory to God. It's always happening like that in the second day of the service. It's like the anointing start here and it turns up and it turns up. And then by the time the last day come, the climax come.
All right.
I'm going to tell you something. Right. I'm going to challenge you as people of God. If you want your relatives to be healed,
that's right.
Don't let them miss the service
all
tomorrow.
Right.
Amen. All
right.
If you want to be delivered financially, don't miss this service tomorrow.
Amen.
Glory to God. Let's clear the air. It ain't got nothing to do with Apostle Church.
All right.
Because it's not by my power, nor by my might, but by his spirit, saith the Lord of hosts. So I ain't going to try to take no glory for myself. Like he's something special to come see me. I'm telling you and challenging you, if you want something, come with a spirit of expectation that I'm going to get some deliverance. I'm going to be set free. I'm going to get my financial breakthrough. Glory to God. And one thing I've learned, when you get into the presence of God, when you get into his, in the presence of his spirit, that the oil pours from the Father unto his children.
All right. Come on. All right.
Glory to God.
All right. All right.
Glory to God. I told you this yesterday that I was going to bring you part two. The cross that break you. Glory to God. And we were talking about some very strategical things that can help us to build ministry, that can help us to raise the anointing, that can help us to deliver somebody.
All right.
Because let me explain something to you, beloved, that healing comes through you. The scripture tells us, after ye shall receive power. Glory to God. And then the scripture tells us over in Mark, right around the 16th chapter, it says, these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. And if they take up service or drink any deadly thing, it shall not harm them. And they shall lay hands on the sick. And they shall recover. How many of y'all are believers in the house? How many of y'all know that you are a believer? So if you a believer, slap somebody with a high five and say that I'm here, but I don't need a apostle. I'm here because I'm coming to Jesus. My deliverance comes from Jesus. Yes. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. See, we gotta shake off some stuff. And we gotta stop looking all pretty. We gotta come up in here and get stupid for God. The Bible declares that I'm a fool for Jesus. Glory to God. So if I got any fools in the building, give them a shout. Younger. Glory to God.
Amen.
Yeah, I'm a third generation preacher. My great grandfather was a second generation.
Amen.
Glory to God. And I'm not going to give you my long drawn out testimony.
Amen.
But I'm going to tell you, church didn't let out at no 1 o'clock. Because see one thing about it, Jesus didn't show up at 1.
Amen.
He didn't. See, we want to time Jesus. If Jesus don't show up in the next 30 minutes, I gotta go home. I gotta wash my hair, and I gotta get ready for work, and I gotta. Oh my God, I gotta get me something to eat. I gotta feed the babies, and I gotta wash some clothes, and I gotta do all kinds of things. But see, by the time you did all of that stuff, glory to God, you just missed your breakthrough. Glory to God. See, we got to go back, beloved, to those old days where they had multiple shut-ins.
All right.
If you want to see a change in your ministry, begin to do some shut-ins.
Right.
Glory to God. Because see, a lot of folks, they want a microwave message.
All right.
Glory to God. They want Jesus to show up and plug him in, put the hot spot in the hot pocket in the microwave, and then put it on 2 minutes, and then Jesus pop out and say, here's your heat.
All right.
It don't work like that with God.
Amen.
But that's what we want.
Amen.
But the Bible declares that we have to learn how to worship.
Amen.
Worship sets the atmosphere.
All right.
Worship brings us into the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God. See, guess what? I can guarantee y'all, when y'all go, come on now, I can guarantee y'all when y'all go to heaven, ain't nobody gonna be sitting there looking at me crazy.
All right. That's all right.
They gonna be running, jumping, skipping, trying to get to Jesus.
Amen.
But I know they're gonna go shout.
All right.
But this is your preview of your heavenly experience.
All right.
If we don't learn how to do it here, then how in the world are we going to do it in heaven? Then that's all we have to do.
All right.
Guess what?
All right.
See, in heaven, there is no time or no space.
All right.
So you ain't going to be able to go to heaven and time Jesus. Because, see, the angels going to look at you like you're stupid.
Amen.
Glory to God. They're going to be like, you come up here, you can't. What kind of Lord you thought you were serving? Glory to God. See, a lot of times we serve man.
Amen.
Instead of serving God.
All right.
Let's get into this message. The cross that break you. My question to you this evening, are you available for Jesus? Glory to God. Are you available? Yeah, I know y'all probably thought, hey, apostle getting ready to come and preach a prosperity message, and folk gonna fall on the floor, and all those things. Let me tell you something. If we don't get right here, it don't matter how much I say you're gonna be blessed, you ain't gonna get nothing until you humble yourself and surrender.
That's right.
If you look at Ephesians 4, it tells us that the apostles are for the perfecting of the saints. Amen. So I'm not a prosperity preacher, you know.
Amen.
I preach it, but I'm not a prosperity preacher. That's not my aim. My aim is to help you and I get to heaven.
Amen.
Because when I preach to you, I'm preaching to me.
All right.
Glory to God.
Amen.
And if I'm not going to put my soul in jeopardy,
All right.
Woe to the man that feeds himself.
Amen.
And not the flock of God. I'm telling you what's in Ezekiel 34.
Mm-hmm.
He called us to feed the flock.
Mm-hmm.
To empower you. To equip you.
Mm-hmm.
So you can live a successful life. And so you can do what God has called you to do.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Are you available for Jesus?
Amen.
Let's turn to Luke, the 14th chapter. I'm going to give y'all scripture. Glory to God. I believe in giving you the word. Let's go to 14 16 through 35. 16 through 35. Glory to God. Amen. If you got it, say amen. If you don't, say wait on me.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Most people can find Luke real fast. Amen. The scripture tells us, glory to God. Then he said unto them, a certain man made a great supper and bade many. I take an apostolic authority over every unclean spirit.
Amen.
I take authority over all witchcraft.
Amen.
All spirit of complacence.
Amen.
I bind it and I loose it to the pit.
Amen.
That comes with surrender, y'all. We got to begin to surrender ourselves to Jesus in every aspect of our lives so we can be able to be delivered. How many of y'all wants a touch from Jesus today? Glory to God. Glory to God. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Because guess what? Jesus is here to bring deliverance and set the captives free. If you want prayer, you come forward and just come forward right here and we'll pray for you. Glory to God. Glory to God. Anybody else? Anybody else? You can just line up straight across the front. Jesus. Jesus. Man of God, can you anoint each person, please? No, you come forward. You need you right here. Jesus. Amen. I surrender. I surrender. I surrender. Glory to God. Surrender all. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Just begin to worship Him. Everyone close their eyes that's on the altar. And just begin to think on Jesus. Oh, no, 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 shit. Na, 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 shaka. Yes, God. Yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Glory to God. You might want to get behind. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, thank you. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you. Come forward, daughter. Come forward. Come forward. Yes, yes. Glory to God. 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 There's things that you've been asking God to do in your life. Glory to God. There is an immediate need. Turn it down. Turn it down. Glory to God. There is an immediate need. Amen. There's an immediate need that you need right now. Am I right about it? Am I right about it? Amen. I don't want nobody thinking I'm a lying prophet.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. I hear in my spirit all. Glory to God. Because there's been some heartbreak in your life. A lot of letdowns. Glory to God. I'm going to put down this mic.
Can y'all still hear me?
Yes.
Amen. Glory to God. But God wants to heal you and touch you today. Amen. And deliver you. Come forward, brother. Yes, Jesus. glory. Touch.
Alright.
Touch your right hand.
Yes, Lord.
Touch your
right hand.
Alright. Touch your right hand.
Yes, Lord.
Touch your right hand. Point to where the pain is. Woman of God, point to where the pain is. Or is that a private matter? Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Touch her right now. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Touch her right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Glory to God. All the hurt, all the pain, Lord. Jesus. Touch. Touch. Touch.
Maya.
Touch. 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 Touch right now, Jesus. 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 Touch right now, Jesus.
Touch right now, Jesus.
Jesus.
Yes,
Jesus. Come forward, woman of God. Come forward. Come forward here. Lift your hands. There's something that's been trying to depress you. Am I right? It's a burden. And it's become a spirit of heaviness. And you've been crying out to the Lord, Lord, you got to deliver me from this. Because it's becoming too much for me to bear. Is it financial? Financial? Glory to God. But you could use a financial breakthrough. Amen. No, I wasn't hearing that. Amen. This is family issues. Family hurt. You so deeply to the point where you really haven't even told the one that have hurt you how deeply it's hurt. Am I right? Hurt you so deeply. Sometimes it's hard to forgive. Sometimes when people just do you wrong, especially the ones you love the most. It becomes hard to forgive. Grant her the gifts in the name of Jesus. All the pain, all the hurt go in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
in the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Glory to God. Come on, daughter. You're in high school, right? Mm-hmm. You're a freshman. Mm-hmm. A lot of pressure, right? Look in here. Look in here. Sometimes they make you angry. Mm-hmm. Don't.
Yes,
Lord. sometimes it makes you, sometimes you don't even want to go to school. Am I right? Damn. Guess who would have to deal with the same thing? To the point she said, Daddy, homeschool me. Because I'm tired of these children. Now, there's a lot of pressure. They're always trying to tell you to do something that you don't want to do. They're always trying to get you involved in stuff that you don't want to be involved in.
Amen.
And sometimes they feel like you don't even have the strength to just say no.
You know what I'm saying?
But God's going to grant you the strength, Lord. Put your hands and close your eyes. Lord God, touch you from the crown of our head to the soul of our knees. Give her the strength, God, to stand for you. For you said, if you would deny me for this adulterous and sinful generation, I will deny you before my Father. But Lord, she wants to admonish you. She wants to praise you. But the pressure of her age group, Lord, help her. In the name of Jesus. Touch! God's going to give you a blessed peace.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Amen.
Look. Let me explain something to you. You are not what they say you are.
That's right.
You understand what I'm saying? Yes. You know what I'm talking about, right? Yes. You don't have to do what they tell you to do.
Amen.
Because if they were really your friends, they
Amen.
Wouldn't tell you to do wrong. You know what I'm saying? So, it's nothing wrong with saying no. And so, sometimes it means walking alone. But guess what? If you trust God, though, God's going to send you some good sanctified friends.
Amen.
That's going to do what your standards are. Mm-hmm. But I warn you, you have to live holy too. You have to stand for Jesus. Even in a hard, tough world.
Amen.
It gets hard on these kids. Bless you. Bless you.
Amen, amen,
bless
amen.
You. What's going on, baby girl? Nothing. Don't look like nothing. What's going on? You in school too? It's rough, ain't it? You want to knock one of them little boys upside the head. They just bother you all the time. Lift your head up. Lift your hands up, girl. Father, touch this child.
Yes, Lord.
Give her, oh God, the ability and the strength.
Yes,
stand for you, Jesus.
Yes,
he said, suffer the little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of heaven. And Lord, we decree right now your hedge of protection about them and protect them from hurt, harm, and danger. In
yes,
Jesus'
Lord.
Name.
Yes,
amen. Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hey, woman of God. What's going on?
Amen.
See, when people don't look at me in the eye, that tells me something's going on.
That's right. I don't look anybody in the eye. I can't do it.
The eyes are the window gate to the soul.
That's right.
And ain't too many people can look me straight in the eye for a long period of time. You know, see, there's always things that's in our lives that we want God to move, but we have to make a decision and a stand for Him. You know?
Amen.
It's not always easy. You're a single mother. Single mother. Daddy just don't do nothing, right? He's a knucklehead.
Yeah.
You've been praying that God deal with them, huh?
The child support.
I tell you what. Tonight is your chance to be blessed. Sow a seed. Sow a seed. Now let God lead you now, okay? I ain't gonna tell you to sow no rent money and no electric bill money, nothing like that.
Amen.
You let God lead you. You sow a seed. And when you sow it, you bring it up here and you say, Lord, this is for my child support.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And this Negro should have gave me a long time ago.
Amen.
And watch what God does. Lift your hands up, Lord. Hands up, sir. But that's where it hurts. Right in the heart. The stress. Stress of parenting. Glory to God. Touch her right now. In the name of Jesus. Touch her and give her.
Yes, Lord, my man, I. Yes, Lord, no weapon, my man, see, my man, yeah. No weapon for him, my man, see, my man, see. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Increase my me, see. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Increase my me, see. Daughter, now see me, my see. Increase my me, my see.
This child, God. Stir up the gift within her.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Lord, the enemy is trying to sift her.
Yes, Lord.
As wheat. Trying to convert a mind and a heart from following you. But I take an Ecclesiastes 3-chord strength.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, yes.
And I bind your spirit to her. In the name of Jesus. Right now.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus. Glory. Empower her now, Lord. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
How you feel now, baby girl?
Amen.
What's going on, young man? Huh? Nothing. There's always nothing with you children, huh? Give your hand, son. Glory to God. Are you saved? You're saved? You gave your life to Jesus? Amen. Amen. Now see, guess what, y'all? The enemy's trying to rob these young men. They're trying to take their lives.
Amen.
Glory to God. Pastor, it's our responsibility to hedge them. Because too many of them dying. Too many of them dying. And the devil's trying to take them out at a young age. Trying to get them involved in gangs and drugs.
Amen.
Glory to God. They need men of God like me and you. That's going to speak life into them.
That's right.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Lord, I pray that you open his ears.
Yes.
I pray you make him a preacher, God.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Open his ears, God. Let him hear your voice. In the name of Jesus. And Father, I give you praise. Don't worry, son. I ain't going to push you back.
Yes, sir.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.